Hello guys, welcome to my first ever tutorial video. My name is Sel, and in this video I'm going to show you how to use the risk management tool. Alright, so this template has been designed to help safety professionals save time managing health and safety by actually helping the organizations to maintain a safe and secured workplace that is without risk to the health and safety of workers. And you know that that is done effectively by doing your hazard identification and risk assessment, and that is done on a risk register. So we have a very structured approach for conducting your risk assessment on a risk register by just indicating your location, the activity, the person at risk, the risk category, the risk ID, identifying the hazards, identifying the unwanted event or the risk, and doing an initial risk assessment, okay, or risk analysis, where you would identify the likelihood and the level of severity, okay, to estimate the risk rating, which would provide the risk level. After that, you implement your mitigations, or you provide the mitigations, and you do a final risk assessment to further reduce the risk to a level that is as low as reasonably practicable. And then you provide who is responsible for these controls. You provide a time frame for implementation of the controls and who has approved the risk assessment. Often somebody in a higher authority like the safety manager or the general manager or the MD. Okay, so there's a comprehensive risk assessment that you would usually do to have a full overview of your risk profile within your organization. And as I earlier mentioned, what is interesting to note is that you are able to effectively follow up on the control measures for each risk that have been identified. So by just selecting the risk ID, automatically the report will populate the date, the location, the department or location, the hazards, the mitigation, and you count the number of mitigations and provide the number right here. And ideally you're supposed to know which controls have been implemented. So if you know the controls that have been implemented, you indicate the number of controls out of the list of controls right here, and automatically you know the controls that are pending, which you provide over here, and then the person responsible. So you engage the person to find out any progress updates of these controls, and you provide them here, and they indicate as either open or closed, and automatically also identify the or know the level of percentage that have been completed automatically. So this you can do for all the risks that have been identified based on your risk assessment. As you are aware, you'll be indicating the risk ID as you are populating the report, so you're able to select by the risk ID for all these to populate automatically. Another interesting thing, as you are aware, is the dashboard. The dashboard is populating automatically from these two source data sheets, okay, and it helps you to visualize the qualitative data that we've input into the template. We are at this dashboard is not based on just raw figures like what you see on the market or other people, but it's based on qualitative data. So you're able to visualize and be have fun with doing your risk assessment. And then also you have other reports right here that are populating automatically. So this template is just for safety professionals to enjoy doing health and safety, enjoy doing their risk assessment, enjoy doing their follow-up, because there's a dashboard that actually reflects exactly how you're performing. Okay, now the dashboard is very comprehensive. You're able to tell the risk control pending, the risk percentage of risk control that be implemented. You have the overall, the risk control level. You also have risk control level according to the category. So we have safety and environment. You also have status of risk control based on the numbers that was identified and what have been implemented. And we have the risk level after mitigation. So having implemented all the controls, you would be able to now tell which of the levels of risk are within medium and high or low. And the highest number would then tell you that overall you have majority of your risk within the medium risk category. And that's and you can actually go beyond that to make sure that all your risk within your organization are actually within the low risk category, having implemented effective risk control strategy. And then, as you know, the end result is to reduce risk to a level that is as low as reasonably practicable. So this template actually works effectively. It's just a plug and play template. and to be able to confirm that it's simply a plug and play, let's begin by just deleting the data, because ideally when you purchase or when you grab this template, you'd have to input your own data. So let's just do that, okay, and then see what happens in the template. So I'll do that right away for all of you to see. It's simply a plug and play, just plug in your data and that's it, you're already running. Okay. Okay, now having deleted our data from the risk register, interestingly, you'll notice that on our risk control tracker, our data have equally vanished. So we just delete the rest in there, because these ones we entered them manually when you were populating the report. We would delete this one as well. And then delete the final one. All right, so there's no data in our risk control tracker as well. Now there's an interesting thing, the very important thing that we need to do for this dashboard to equally present the reality on the ground. So we click on refresh all and everything goes back to zero. So there's nothing to show, as you can see, because there's no data in our risk management tool. So that is a clear evidence that the template is a plug and play template. You only provide your data and then you'd follow up on the controls based on the risk ID, and then you have the dashboards and all the other reports populating automatically. And if you want to change your department, it's just right here. You can just change the department to, let's say lifting department, okay, and then you come to the risk register. When you start inputting your data, you select by the drop down, you select the lifting department, you provide an activity like lifting operations, you know, persons at risk could be the crane operator, the banksman and the riggers, or the maybe passes by because the area has to be secured and stuff like that. So that's it, guys. Let's try and bring back our data just to make sure that everything comes back to how it was before. Okay, so it's simply plug and play. We are just plugging back our data and let's see what happens. We didn't even have to click on refresh all. Okay, so everything just comes back. But in your case, after entering every data or any changes, you need to go to the data and refresh all. That'll help the dashboard to present the latest changes that have been made into the template. Okay, so having had a comprehensive risk assessment like this, you should note that your risk assessment must be reviewed regularly based on changes in all these factors. It could be changing the activity, changing the personnel or persons affected. It could be changing the, or it could be an additional hazard or a new hazard have been identified. You come and update it and make sure that your ratings are all correct based on the reality on the ground. So this is a qualitative risk assessment, as you're all aware, based on subjective classification of the risk level based on likelihood and then severity. So this template is the best that I think you guys can use for now. So if you're interested, just click on the link below and see you on the other side.